Like and subscribe in the next 5 seconds, or when Galactus arrives, your game might crash in the Nexus War live event. The Fortnite 14.60 update went live today, and with that said, despite all the cool things already leaked from the files in terms of upcoming or new cosmetics, the Venom Cup that Fortnite have announced we can earn as a free skin alongside his pickaxe, the main thing everybody's looking forward to, considering not only is Chapter 2 Season 5 ready with 15.00 being on the staging servers, is the Galactus live event, or the Devourer of Worlds, should I say. Even though he went rogue just before the update went live anyways and disappeared from being a distant object approaching, let's just say now, with downtime occurring and obviously data miners pulling things out of the game's coding early, we have an early look of what this event will be like in-game that we're able to participate in to stop the Devourer of Worlds, as the name of the LTM itself we need to enter in order to defeat Galactus. And in the final days until then, despite the countdown timer yet to be implemented in-game ticking away until the moment this occurs, and some other stuff developing in the Battle Pass section on this holographic table, let's just say when the moment occurs of the timer reaching zero anyways, once it's added, this will be the biggest event that Fortnite has ever seen, and for that reason you might want to stick around until the end to find out, well, why you might not be able to play Fortnite soon after it happens, as we're going back into the black hole. So before we enter the black hole and can't send any gifts, don't worry, we're gonna send some. However, still, for whatever reason, there's only around 30% of you subscribed to the channel, meaning 70% aren't eligible to receive a gift at all. And I'll give you guys a deal: if this lands on heads, that means you need to click the subscribe button. I did. And just to be safe, yeah, here's the red card. I'm gonna pull that too, because we're incredibly close to another milestone being 2.1 million before 2021. And with that said, now it's time we splashed out the 2020 V-Bucks remaining, so we don't really have anything anymore. But before we do, good news: obviously most people will have the brand new item shop right now, and when you happen to go over to here, make sure, of course, you're entering code FriendlyMachine. As an Epic partner, it greatly supports the channel, and I'm one of very few YouTubers that literally proves in every video I actually send gifts. So if you want to feel like you're using a code to help out a creator that actually gives back to their community, then make sure to enter my code. It does reset every 14 days, but after entering it over and over again, as you can see, it's on the predictive text, so then all you really need to do is click accept. And with that said, as we're about to enter the event now, I figured it's only right we gift the scorecard to 5 of you guys, considering then you can rate the event itself. So if you want to be like any of the 5 guys I'm gifting right now, simply make sure you're subscribing to the channel with all notifications turned on, and then comment your Epic Games ID down below, so perhaps, fingers crossed, nobody has it. Oh my god, there's always one. So that's a first. He already owns the item, and on top of that, despite adding me as a YouTuber, you know, who gifts people, he can't receive gifts, okay? And yeah, hopefully this could be you, or me sending you a gift anyways, in the next video. And yeah, despite Galactus not being able to be seen now off the back of the helicarrier, trust me, soon he's literally gonna be big enough to the point where it's impossible to not notice him. Also, in terms of today's map changes, I don't believe we've seen anymore, really. It literally just seems to be a matter now of the island preparing for the arrival of Galactus, you know, with the battle bus getting upgraded as it's in its second stage. But here's what data miners managed to find early: the third upgraded stage for the Iron Man or Stark Industries upgraded battle bus. And I'm guessing this is going to be the battle bus we enter the live event in on as the final upgraded version. That's just based off, you know, how often we've seen it upgraded anyways. What's this guy doing? Shooting some walls? Scuba Jonesy, you're not really a dog though. But anyways, one of the most interesting things leaked today was actually the next development for the Battle Pass menu. As you guys may or may not know, all this season we've been seeing subtle things updated throughout here. And despite this imminent threat kind of exclamation point also indicating that yes, the ruins is gonna be a big focal point of this event, or where it will be taking place, we're soon gonna, what are you doing, man? We're soon going to be seeing Galactus literally kind of size comparison compared to our map, as this ultimately, the challenge table, is an overview of the island we're playing on. And I'm just saying, if this is the case, he's going to be completely huge, literally like up here in the sky, maybe bigger than Travis Scott, but we know that's kind of confirmed either way, like compared to Travis Scott, because the game files for this event, as you can see, are 4 gigabytes. Now, this is bigger than any other event we've ever seen, literally bigger than the end event itself, where we originally went into the black hole and then Galactus actually, you know, felt the power of the zero point to harness it on this new reorganized island. And also the final showdown, believe it or not, with these two giant beings destroying certain parts of our old map, and then eventually, well, kind of each other, with the robot only having one arm remaining, and then the polar peak monster, well, you know, literally being skewered through the head. And speaking of the robot, I think it would be cool if we could see him return to this brand new map in the Galactus Live event, or to fend him off from devouring the Fortnite world anyways, as we never knew where he flew off to, and we've never seen him since. And obviously Epic employees like Donald Mustard and stuff like that were teasing that, yes, it's going to be linked everything together, you know, the Fortnite storyline with our characters that Epic Games have created, and the Marvel characters that have been collaborated into the storyline. And I'm just saying, people speculate off this loading screen or kind of tease of what's to come with Galactus devouring the world against our superheroes and Fortnite characters. These stars are supposedly representing the Seven, as they seem to be brighter, these Seven, than all the others in the sky, meaning they're going to return to in their rockets. And based off what's already been revealed about the event itself, here's an early look of Galactus emerging over this side of the Fortnite island, which is absolutely insane. And although we still have yet to see the countdown timer in-game and potentially in the pre-game lobby battle pass menu too with the hologram of Galactus, it's most likely going to be appearing here above the ruins, as not only was the exclamation point above here on the challenge table itself, but it's the center point of our map, and I'm guessing we're going to be taking a stand at least near Stark Industries, you know, to do with everything that's being kind of innovated or developed this season in terms of technology to fight off Galactus, to give us at least a fighting chance. Oh, that was awful. What are you guys doing? It's not quite Christmas yet. You're now famous because about 100,000 people have just seen your gamertag. Are you weak, dude? Yeah, it's safe to say he was. What's going on over here? We have Kit on the floor, we have people jumping around. Hopefully we can all pull together in the event, that's all I'm gonna say. Can't get away from me, man. Face up to the reality before it's devoured. But yeah, speaking of the event itself, this is actually gonna be contained in the LTM, the Devourer of Worlds, as it was described, of Galactus in the Season 4 launch trailer, where we, you know, saw Galactus announced as the Devourer of Worlds himself. And although the loading screen's already been leaked for what this will be as a preset when entering this LTM, I'm finding it kind of hard to comprehend, you know, how our tiny and insignificant weapons will deal damage against this giant being, which is Galactus, already teased through the leaked images and, you know, the battle pass table. Wait, what? I nearly ran myself over. What is this loadout, man? It's messier than my bedroom. And with it making sense for the timer to appear at the center of the island and, you know, the event actually take place, or mainly go down everything important there in terms of the destruction or what Galactus is trying to accomplish. And I don't know if I've mentioned this already, but the sound files for the timer as well also got leaked in this update, despite, you know, the timer itself getting leaked prior. Can I get a break from the storm? I'm just a 6-foot banana trying to win a game of Fortnite. But yeah, I'll stop talking real quick and let you guys just listen to how insanely intense this makes the event sound. How cool was that? Literally makes me even more hyped for the event, and we don't know as of right now if we're going to be seeing a timer in the lobby like what we saw counting down until the device being the last live event, which was record-breaking in terms of the amount of people that attended, because, you know, 12 million people were literally witnessing it live in-game, let alone the other people who couldn't make it in-game because the servers were full and, you know, got referred to social media platforms such as Twitch, YouTube, and other areas, I guess. And despite everything already mentioned in this video determining that the event overall is just going to be completely huge, let's just say that it might not be fully conclusive and may continue into the next season. As traditionally in comic books, you know, we see the to be continued if they want to leave us on a cliffhanger. Well, let's just say this wording got added into the coding. What are you doing, Doom Henchman? I literally can't run this guy over. What's he doing? What on earth is going on with him? Is this dude invincible? Okay, maybe not. But yeah, this ultimately could mean, considering the Fortnite servers are going to be shut off with this effect in the lobby, or should I say the helicarrier, that is going to be coming over the map, as we've been able to determine for literally so long now, based off not only the keycard and vault on the helicarrier itself, but from data miners pulling this into the game early above where it's going to be positioned. Get back in the storm, man. We don't want you over here. And with the only other event being the black hole itself that sucked everything in, the item shop, everything to do with all the menus, the lobby, I'm just saying, I don't want to be witnessing this event from the lobby. It's one of the ones I don't want to miss in game. And it's one of the Seven. Have you arrived early on the island to take out Galactus? Maybe not. If you defeated this easy, honestly, I have my doubts. Beep, beep, mother trucker.